I'm excited to kind of be back on schedule and continuing work on the chimp we start on Tuesday. It's a different chimp that I started last Thursday. I kind of put that one away because I decided that this is the chimp that I really wanted to work on for a while. So I'm just gonna get started and just try. The goal today is to try to work out this side of the face in this next hour. Oh, I'm gonna sneeze. No, I'm okay. Perfect timing. Oh man, my allergies are so bad today. So let's get started. I'm gonna put some music in my ear. So if you have any questions, feel free to ask. And now I have a charcoal or something on my lip. Perfect. I think it's animal hair because I am just so sneezy. And ironically, I'm allergic to most animals, but it's gotten a lot better. But sometimes the pet dander gets me a little bit. Okay, here we go. So I don't know if I'll just do a quick recap of this chimp that I'm drawing here. This is a photo that I took of myself at the LA Zoo quite a long time ago. And it was the last time I was actually even able to bring myself to go to any place where animals are kind of confined. And this chimp looked right into me and I just kind of got it. And it's kind of a real pivotal time in my life where I just really like opened my heart up and just changed my perspective on a lot of things. And this chimp was kind of the catalyst for that. So it's a really special animal to me. And I was sitting at my new studio and I found this old photo. So I felt it was really important to kind of to draw him again. Him or her, I don't know the gender of this chimp. And in the background, I can actually hear it. Oh, thank you. You can actually hear the dog snoring. I don't know if you can hear it. Ah! No, I would never assume. That's funny. I don't know how good the audio is, but Rufus, my big boxer, is snoring so loud right now on the couch. I can hear it over my earphone. Oh, it's not coming through on the mic, but I'm sure you can imagine. It's interesting after looking. Ah, good morning, Kiki Cat. Laz, that's right. Thank you. Continuing work on Laz today. I'm kind of just revisiting it a little bit with an eraser before I draw, just to get kind of reacquainted with the shapes. Hi, Kim. Oh, thank you. I really love this chimp. I'm so excited that I found the photo the other day. Just looking at it, this face is just so expressive. You can make so many decisions just by doing this lightly, and nothing is permanent here, which is what's so nice about the process. He's snoring so loud. This is a 2B, but I also just pulled a B out of the back. Aha, here it is. I want to make the marks really light still before I make too many big decisions. So I went from the 2B to a B, and it's, you know what, let me zoom in so you could see this. There we go. Okay. Can you see how faint these lines are? Really beautiful soft gray right now from this B. So I could push this back just a bit. Oh, I'm covering it. Let me try to draw from this side. You could see just a littlest of tone right there. Helps build up the textures and kind of the creases. Oh, thank you, Kim. I think I can actually pull it. No, let me see. A little bit. Even. Oh, here we go. Make sure it's not too blurry this close, but I'll do a little bit of mark making so you can kind of see how faint. Let me see. Here we go. Oh, gosh, you can see. Let's move this. I feel like my heart beating is shaking this desk right now. I have to be careful. Oh, hello. How do I get the smooth shading? Well, I do a lot of different things. Right now I'm using a B carbon pencil to kind of lightly hash out some texture, but I do a lot of blending in my artwork and I'm just using my finger here, but I also use Q-tips quite often to kind of blend it out and get a lot of that soft tone. So I kind of just use a combination. And sometimes just having that tone on my Q-tip is enough to put new tone down. See, it actually can actually just put the light tone on there without even touching it to a pencil, touching pencils to the paper. And I'm zoomed in really tight right now, so it looks a little bit different from far away, but it's still got a really soft feeling to it. I'm like right at the tip here. Let me zoom out just a little bit. There we go. Because I'm running out of desk here, I keep pushing it up. So now I'm going to go over it with a Q-tip and kind of just spread this out a little bit. Shrink his jaw a little bit. Aw, thank you, Kiki Cat. That's too sweet. This is just a really special chimp. I want to do it justice. Can see just been building up a little bit of layering here, and I'm starting to get this direction now. Sometimes there's little detail work. You can't see too much difference, maybe on the camera, but it's what really gives it that super soft feeling and really makes it feel alive and gives this chimp his or her really special, unique characteristics. I want to bring this side in just a little bit. See what it looks like. Sometimes I'm looking at different perspectives, the photo, the drawing, on my TV. And sometimes when I really can't figure it out, I'll take a photo of it on my cell phone and just kind of look at it. Because it's like compacts it all into the screen, and that can be a helpful tool sometimes too, to catch what's off or get the whole picture basically. But all these great tools that kind of are around now because of modern technology. Oh, I forgot to text my mom this morning. I'm gonna just text her real quick. See, all this stuff comes to me as I'm drawing. I'm like, oh, I was supposed to do this. I was supposed to do this. I don't do it now, I'll forget though. Oh, I'm covering again. Well, he is out cold, look at that guy. So what this needs down here is me to come in with a little bit of a darker pencil to kind of push that contrast. I'm not going to do it right now, but I will be doing that soon because I'm ready. Let me give it a little bit more length here at the bottom of his chin. I'm going to move up to a 2B now for just a bit. You hear him now? He's snoring so loud. Oh my gosh, he is out. Sometimes I have to twist the paper a little bit, get a better angle. Oh, sure. Let me zoom in. Kim, is this good, or do you want to do even about like this? How's this work? You can see the lines better here. I look crooked. Second eye is always more difficult. First eye sets it, and the second eye you've gotta. But again, just like humans, they're not perfectly symmetrical, but look at this. See this section right here? Feels really long. But when I look at the photo, I can't really see it, but that's the same shape there. And I look here and I go, well, that's the same shape, right? So now I have to make a decision. in the photo, because of how dark it is, in fact, it's a photo, not a drawing, it's not, doesn't stand out as much. When I look at this, it makes it feel so different than the other eye that I'm gonna just make a few little adjustments. Like pull the pupil in just a tiny bit more. Again, this is tough because I don't want to lose individuality of this particular chimp. So I'm going to have to play around with this just a little bit. And this is the part of the photograph that's really degraded, so I'm just gonna have to kind of guess what happens in this part of the eye. Sorry. I'm trying to draw without covering it the whole time. I've got three dogs here today again, Tuesday. Got Lilo till tomorrow. She's too hot to sleep on the couch with the other dog. She's sleeping over here on the ground. Hey, Lilo. Hi, pretty girl. She's such a sweetheart. Zoom out so we can see the hole starting to come together. You can see how much lighter this side still is. It really needs to be worked in a lot more, but it's getting there. Let's see, I have about 10 more minutes. I'm not going to finish this whole side, but we'll have a little bit more time to get a little bit more detail in this face here. Okay, I think we're good for today. So Tuesday of next week, I'll be back and we'll continue working on this guy. I'm pretty happy where things are landing. So we can tighten up the face and really push the contrast and then decide what extras are gonna go on here and what I'm gonna do with the rest of this composition. Okay, stop fidgeting. Okay, I'm gonna go work on some other artworks. So thank you everybody for joining and I'll be back next Tuesday. Have a fantastic day.